It says in Hebrews chapter 8 and verse 13 that the new covenant has made the old covenant obsolete. So if the old covenant is obsolete, how could anyone be saved? By keeping the old covenant, which is no longer valid.
That brings up a new question, though. The old covenant is obsolete. But in Romans 3, the last verse, and I'm flipping pages, it says, do we then by this faith make the law of no effect? Do we overthrow it or make it a dead letter? Certainly not. On the contrary, we confirm and establish and uphold the law.
That's right.
Can you comment on what is the confusion or the difference between that and the verse in Hebrews?
Well, Paul certainly wasn't confused. I think many people get confused about Paul's meaning there at the end of Romans 3. When he says we uphold and confirm the law, he doesn't mean that we re-impose the law on believers. What he means is that in preaching justification by faith, we are confirming what the law itself teaches. And he means by that what the Torah teaches. And he's thinking of Genesis because he goes immediately into a discussion of that. He says in the very next verse, for what shall we say our father Abraham has found? Now, Abraham's story is found in Genesis. That's in the Torah, in the law. And what Paul points out is that in the law, it says that Abraham believed in the Lord and it was counted to him for righteousness. So he's saying this justification by faith, that applied to Abraham. That's in the law. That's in the Torah. So he says, when we preach that we're justified by faith apart from the law, we're not somehow saying something hostile to the law. The Torah itself, the law says the same thing. So he's saying we're confirming what the Torah says. And where does it say it? It says it in Genesis 15:6, where Abraham believed in the Lord and it was counted for righteousness. So he's basically saying that the Torah, the law, confirms what he's saying, and he's confirming the Torah. He's not saying that he's imposing the rules and regulations of the law on the new covenant community. He's simply saying that the old covenant anticipated the new covenant, and what he's preaching is very agreeable with what the law said would happen, and it has happened with the coming of